So we will be having the four flip flops. Those are the SR flip flop, JK flip flop, D flip flop, and the T flip flop. Right? So actually, for all these flip flops, we will be considering this SR and JK and D and T we are going to take, that we are going to consider as the inputs. And then for this, we will be having the Qn and Qn plus 1. Qn will be our present state and Qn plus 1 will be our next state. Okay? So by this way, we are going to get the truth tables. And at the same time, if we want to go for this exception tables, means in this what we are going to take means we will be considering this Qn, that is the present state, and next Qn plus 1, that is next state as the inputs. Okay? So for taking this, by taking these inputs, we have to check these two combinations, that is the this whatever the inputs which we are going to get, that is S and R, or for the J and K, for the J and K, and for T and T, what we are going to get those values, either the logic 0 or logic 1, whatever the value we are going to get, that we will be considering for this excitation tables. That means for the truth tables, it will be opposite for the truth tables, for this excitation tables, right? So now I will be explaining you about regarding the SR flip-flop excitation table. Okay, so first considering, if we want to go for this excitation table, means first we have to know the what is the truth table is there for that particular flip-flop. We have to know that truth table. Then, with the help of that, we are going to draw the excitation table. Okay, so now let's go for the SR flip-flop excitation table. SR flip-flop excitation table. Now for this SR flip-flop, I am writing the input, that is a truth table. SR, and then we will be having the Qn, and next Qn plus 1. Okay? Yes. Right? So now I am taking the conditions as 0, 0, 0, 1, and 1, 0, and 1, 1. Okay? And why I am taking like this means, actually we will be writing this Qn, that is the present state and the next state. This Qn we will be representing as the don't care. Don't care means we don't know whether it is a 0 or 1. Okay? So that is the reason I am taking this extended truth table of this SR flip-flop. That means in one condition I am taking this present state as 0, and in the next condition I am taking it as 1. Similarly 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. That means again here the same combination will be repeated like this. 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1. Okay? So, you know the truth table of this SR flip-flop. For the, when this S and R are, both this S and R are 0, that is the logic 0, we are going to get that this next state, that is as the Qn only. That means if the Qn is 0, we are going to get that next state as 0, or if it is 1, means we will be writing it as 1. So that is the reason I am writing here as 0 and 1. So bracket, you can write it as Qn. Right? And next, for the next combination, when S is equal to logic 0 and R is equal to logic 1 means, for this combination, we will be getting as, that is the, that Qn plus 1, we are going to get it as the 0. That means, the SR flip-flop will be in the reset condition. So, directly I am writing as 0. It will not be depending upon this present state in this condition. And next, the next condition will be 1, 0. That means, when S is equal to logic 1 and R is equal to logic 0, there the particular SR flip-flop will be in the set state. So, I am writing it as 1, 1. And the last condition, when we are going for this S is equal to 1 and R is equal to 1, in this condition, we don't know the flip-flop will be in which state. That means, indeterminate state we are going to consider. So, this is the condition. This is the extended truth table, how we are going to write for a particular flip-flop. Now, with the help of this, we are going to draw the excitation table. As I have said, how we are going to write this excitation table is, we will be considering this present state and the next state as the inputs. Okay? So, here I am writing Qn and Qn plus 1. Okay? And now, we have to get the values of this S and R. Okay, so again the four combinations 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1. So for these combinations, what is our S and R values we are going to get, that we have to check. So how we are going to get that? We have to check in this truth table. So this is our truth table, right? So now, the first condition was Qn is equal to 0 and Qn plus 1 is equal to 0. 0. In this truth table, we have to check that. Okay, so here we have got that in this, this is Pn is equal to 0 and Pn plus 1 is equal to 0. Again, we have to check, is there any possibility? Here we are having. Okay, so for that, I am writing here roughly. So, first we are going to check this condition. So, as you can see here, the S and R we are having as the logic 0. I am writing here in this condition. And next, here also the same condition has been repeated, right? So here, what is the value of S we are having? 0. And what is the value of R we are having? 1. Okay? So now, with this, we have to write the excitation table values. Okay? So now, here as you can see, in the first condition, S we are having 0. And in the next condition also, S we are having 0. There is no change, right? So simply, I am writing here, S is equal to 0. Now, when you see for this R condition, for the first condition we will be having 0 and for the next condition we are having 1. That means we don't know the state whether it is a 0 or 1. So that is the reason I am writing it as don't care. Okay? And this is for the first case we have completed. And then the next case is what? Pn is equal to 0 and Pn plus 1 is equal to 1 we have got, right? So that condition we have to check. And where we are going to get here, yeah, as you can see here, in this condition we will be getting, that is Qn is equal to 0 and Qn plus 1 is equal to 1. In the same way, we have to see whether is there any possibility of getting that or not. So here we have not got anything. So simply, in this condition, we will be having S and R values as 1, 0. Okay? So simply, directly we can write this value. So I am writing here as 1 and 0. We have completed the second combination. And next, the next combination is what? 1, 0. Again, we have to check for this 1, 0. Wherever we have got, see, this combination we have got 1, 0. And we are not going to get any repeated combinations, okay? As you can see here, for this, when Pn is equal to 1 and Pn plus 1 is equal to 0, the corresponding logic value is what we are going to get? 0, 1. So, I am writing here as 0, 1. And the last case. The last case is what? Pn is 1 and Pn plus 1 is equal to 1. Okay? Right? So, here we have got that this condition. And next, in this condition, we have got this. Okay? So, these values we have to write. Okay? So, here our X and R values are what? 0, 0. And here our values are 1, 0. As you can see, in this S, we are getting a change. That is, we don't know for this combination whether it is a logic 0 or logic 1. So that is the reason I am writing it as don't care. And R is our this same logic 0. So I am writing it as 0. Okay? So in this case, you will be writing the excitation table value of a particular flip flop. Okay? So you can easily remember this. If you are for the gate purpose, if you are going to remember, that means there is a shortcut, you can see this. If you know these two values means, you can write the exact opposite values of the next two combinations. Okay, so in this way you can remember that. In this way, you will be getting the excitation table value of a particular SR flip flop. Similarly, you can go for the JK also. I am writing here J and K. Okay, so JK means here we will be getting say Qn only and again set and reset state will be same. That means 0, 1. Again 0, 1. 0, 1, 0, 1. Okay? So for all first combination, again if you go for the JK flip flop means, so again you will be getting the, when both inputs, that is J and K is equal to 0, we will be getting it as Qn only. Okay? So here you can write it as 0 and here you can write it as 1. And the second condition is when the inputs are 0 and 1 means the JK flip flop will be in the reset state. So I am simply writing it as 0. And the next condition, when the JK flip flop is, that is inputs are 1 and 0, the flip flop will be in the set state. So I am writing it as 1, 1. And the last condition is, it will be in the toggling condition. So I am writing it as Qn bar. Okay? So toggling means it will be opposite of this present state. Qn is this. This is right. So that is the reason I am writing it as Qn bar. Okay? So here the present state is 0. I am writing it as 1. And here the present state is 1. I am writing it as 0. So I am writing it as Qn bar. And here it is the Qn. Okay? So again, the values will be varying from this JK flip flop. This is J and K. Again, we have to check for all these combinations. J and K I am writing. So the first condition is we have to check for Qn is equal to 0 and Qn plus 1 is equal to 0. So where we are getting these combinations? Here. As you can see, here we will be getting the combination. That means Jk is equal to 0, 0 and right. And in this case, Jk we are having as logic 0 and logic 1. Okay? Right? So, as you can see, the J, for these two conditions, J value we are having same, that is 0. So, I am simply writing representing as J is equal to 0. And as you can see for this K, it is changing, that is 0 to 1, it is going to change there, so we don't know whether it is a 0, logic 0 or logic 1. So, I am simply representing by the don't K. Okay? And again, the second condition for it is for the 0 and 1. Again, you have to check here, where you are going to get that 0 and 1 here. And here we will get, see, here we are getting a 0 and 1 and here also we are getting a 0 and 1. So for this combination we are having J and K values as 1, 0 and for this combination we are having J and K values as 1, 1. Okay? So again, the J is same, that is logic 1 only. I am representing by 1. And as you can see for the K, it is changing from 0 to 1. So I am representing by don't K. Okay? And the next case is what? 1, 0. So again we have to check for 1 and 0. There is our 1 here. We will be getting here 1, 0 and here other combination. As you can see, here is equal to 1 and here plus 1 is equal to 0. Okay? So for that particular combination, we will be having JK values as 0, 1 and the next combination is 1, 1. Okay? So J is changing from 0 to 1. I am representing by don't K. And next K is same, that is logic 1 only. I am writing it as 1. And the last case is what? For the Qn is equal to 1 and Qn plus 1 is equal to 1. This is our combination. And then this is our combination which we are getting here. So for this, the J and K values are what? This is for the 1, 1. So J and K values are 0, 0. And next is what? Here we are getting right. So, and yeah. So, J and K values are 1, 0. Okay? So, J is changing from 0 to 1. That I am writing it as don't K. And K is same, 0, 1. Okay? So, again you can see it will be opposite. Here as you can see, 0 don't K we are getting. For the last combination we will be getting don't K 0. And 1 don't K means here you are going to get as don't K 1. So, in this way you can keep it in mind for the gate purpose. Okay? So this is how we will be writing the excitation tables for the JK flip-flop. Okay, similarly for the D flip-flop also. Yes, this is the D flip-flop and Qn, Qn plus 1. Okay? And next, this will be the present state and the next state. Qn, Qn plus 1 and D. We are going to consider for all these four combinations. So 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1.